what exactly happened and what is Facebook's role in this situation. The issue of Facebook user privacy goes all the way back to 2014. That year, the political research company Cambridge Analytica teamed with a psychology professor at the University of Cambridge and his company Global Science Research. They paid 270,000 users to download their app and take a personality test. This data was then used by the company to choose what political ads to show during the 2016 election. However, not only was the data of the app users accessed, but those users' friends' data as well. When Facebook caught on that Cambridge was accessing over 50 million users' data, they told the company to delete all the data. Last month, on Friday, March 16th, Facebook suspended the global research company from Facebook's platform after finding out via the New York Times that they were still holding on to most of the data. Most recently, on March 20th, the Federal Trade Commission opened an investigation into whether Facebook had violated a settlement reached with a U.S. government agency in 2011 over privacy restrictions. So, since all this news came to light, Facebook has made some changes to its policy. For example, there will now be a central page where all your privacy preferences will be on, so you can all you can change all that on one page versus the 20 different pages that it used to be on. And then additionally, if a user does not use a certain app for 3 months, the app will lose access to that user's information. So on the privacy issue is complex. Facebook has spread its data all over. You can sign in with Facebook from a huge array of apps from Pinterest, Instagram, and Tinder. Once signed in, that app now has access to basic information like your name, birthday, email, and depending on the app, more personal information like your friends, relationship status, political and religious views. So clearly, like, they have a really broad range of your information in their databases. Overall, it is Facebook's responsibility to prevent companies from exploiting user data. So its use in politics. The use of personal data is a controversial issue in politics. In the 2016 election, Ted Cruz spent $6 million on Cambridge Analytica for political campaigning. Now, one point of view could see this as a major invasion of privacy. A company first took data that, without consent, and then used it to manipulate advertisements that user sees. But on the other hand, what Ted Cruz did was a very intelligent move. The internet is a booming source of information, and he used it for his benefit. Overall, I personally believe that Facebook should protect us from identity theft while also allowing certain reputable research companies access to some of our personal data. Cambridge Analytica, however, did abuse its data usage by not deleting the data as Facebook had initially requested. The world of big data is a vast one and with great potential to solve problems and answer complex questions. Meanwhile, Facebook needs to keep other companies in check with the usage of our data. We have entrusted Facebook with our personal information, but not all of these foreign third parties. This is a huge responsibility to behold. Facebook must always be looking out for the good of its users while also managing its business. As the triple P in business law refers to, a good business is one that balances its impact on people, planet, and profit. I believe that as long as Facebook is kept in check by being called out from time to time, issues like this, Facebook can increase its potential to benefit society, contrary to majority belief.